So tell me if you've heard this one before. Marvel Studios comes out with a movie, and it's big. It inspires a lot of people. Everybody is talking about it. Literally, everybody's talking about it. News stations, it's breaking records left and right. And the only thing people can think of is, well, if they can do that, then clearly we can. So let's just try to copy exactly what they did, and we're gonna find success. Yeah, I'm looking at you, DCEU, Suicide Squad, Guardians Wannabe, and various other studios trying to start shared universes. Well, the latest casualty of this happens to be the Black Panther, which as of right now is demolishing box office, and people are looking at it going, well, clearly, it's the diversity that's driving this movie. And while yes, that is a big factor of it, don't make a mistake, let's be real. It is a fantastic movie. It is a movie that is celebrating the culture. It is respecting African heritage. The movie isn't a success just because they put a bunch of people of color into the movie. Don't make that mistake, which is exactly what is happening right now. As it's being reported, theater owners and studios after this past week are already looking at their portfolios, looking for more diverse movies that they want to toss into theaters as soon as possible to reap some of the reward. I can just smell Warner Brothers like now, like looking into their catalog, seeing if they ever had a Black Batman. I could just smell it. Once again, whoever is doing this is clearly missing the point. You have to be respectable. There's been movies before that have had all black casts, okay? This isn't anything new. Here's the thing. You look at the history of these movies, a lot of these movies happen to portray African Americans as people doing robberies, or rap movies starring rappers, you know, and like they're in like the most ghetto places you could imagine. They never celebrated them as actually being something more than that. That is the problem. The reason some of my friends are gravitating towards this movie and love it, it's because of what the message is sending. It's because it's celebrating where these people came from. It's acknowledging the fact of what history has done to African Americans. That's the point of it. Just making a movie for the sake of making a movie that you're going to, in the script, look at it as a studio guy and go, so, this was written for Tom Cruise, right? Well, how about we put Idris Elba in here and then just make the rest of the cast black? That's not what it's about. You're missing the point. And sadly, that's exactly what they're going to be doing. So, I'm guessing in the next, let's say 7 or 8 years, you're going to see a giant surge into people trying to shove people of color and minorities, like Asians, at the forefront of a movie just because they think that's what's going to get them money. But what they're missing is quite clearly the message behind it. But then again, this is guys that are literally like worth $30, $40, $50 billion running these suits, who could care less, and they don't even understand it because money has jaded them so much. They just don't understand why people are gravitating towards Black Panther. And you know, I'm sorry I'm sounding really upset, I'm like right here, it's because I am. I really am. Like, this is just, like, how do you, like, go perceive this movie and say, oh, its success is coming from this, and then completely just try to take that message and go, well, it's actually because it's just all black people in the movie. Yeah, that's why. That's clearly why, studio man. That's clearly why the movie's doing good. Yeah. It just, that's more disrespect than anything right there. Now that they're going to be thinking of looking at movies in that exact way. And that's not what it's about. 100% it's not what it's about. It just blows my mind.